It's very possible that I have not met Kenneth Anger until the premiere of Scorpio Rising in 1964. We premiered it at the filmmakers' showcase. But since then, around that time also, he moved to New York. So we had many more occasions to meet. And, you know, just one thing I could say right now, same as I have said and we will always say about Andy Warhol. Warhol was always had great solidarity with the avant-garde and with I was doing especially. He never let me down. I could always go to him. Kenneth is another one of those. His dedication to the, I mean, he has been in Hollywood. His background is Hollywood and commercial cinema, and he, all his friends, and he admires and idealizes many of the stars. But his real heart is, and dedication in his own work, is the avant-garde film. He will support and won't betray, won't budge, he will be always in there. He may argue and have great, make great, at least he says so, enemies, you know, there, and he has many of them, and that he puts curses on and never talks. But that has nothing to do with his dedication and with his. He's very sensitive to, if he feels that anybody has some bad, wrong intentions, like they come, you know, say, okay, will we give me an interview? Or she sees immediately that there is this person is just, you know, once it came only because he's considered like controversial, some personality. He just wants to do an article for one. He does not do that. He just throws, or when they call me and ask to make the files on Kenneth Anger available for research, I always check with Kenneth. Does that? Did he check with you? And he tells me, you know, no, that person, no, don't. And I know when I meet those people, and I see that they're not the right people to do an article on Kenneth, he's very sensitive to that kind of thing. And of course, there are, you know, parts of his life, and we don't know, you know, much, some periods, and it's a pity, because like we don't know much or anything about his life. I don't know how long he was in Paris, but he spent some time in Paris where, you know, Cocteau was the first one that recognized and wrote about this film, first fireworks, because he has made some other little film before that, though he never released. But we don't know much. There are, you know, holes, gaps in many lives of these, of some of the key personalities, artists of the avant-garde movement. And I have a real defect in myself. One, I have to admit, I never ask, you know, personal questions. So much that if sometimes I have problems. Somebody says, introduces himself or herself, the name, and then I don't get, and then I'm ashamed, to try to ask again. And weeks, months, sometimes years pass. I don't know the name, and I meet again, and then I, somebody sometimes tells me. So I don't dig into the past, into private personal areas of some of my colleagues and friends, and because sometimes I feel, you know, it's I should not do that.